When I was about 8 years old, I started having a little bit of trouble reading the board in class. Then things kept getting worse and worse. I went from having 20/20 vision to having 20/400 vision. The center of my retina ended up dying, and so now I see with my peripheral vision. My disease is probably due to a mutation in a protein that pumps a waste product out of cells in your retina, and that's causes the protein to malfunction. So this waste product builds up and ends up poisoning the cells. I think one of the things that draws me to studying protein dynamics is that it's something that nobody can see. So in some ways, the playing field is a little leveled for me. And so protein folding is the process of assembling a protein. So when protein folding goes awry, you get all these unwanted processes, like proteins clumping together in ways that they shouldn't. And this can give rise to diseases like Alzheimer's, where you have these clumps of proteins that end up killing neurons. We can't build microscopes that can zoom into the size scale that proteins exist on. And so one of the powerful ways we have of getting at these processes is simulating them on a computer. But this poses a really big challenge because they're extremely expensive calculations. Just to give some numbers, some of the processes that we're interested in studying related to antibiotic resistance, if I was to try to simulate them on my really powerful MacBook Pro, it would take something like 500 years of computer time. So folding at home is basically a really big distributed computing cluster, where the idea is that in order to get enough computers to tackle some of these enormous calculations that we want to perform, we ask people to volunteer to run simulations on their personal computers and send back the data.
And it helps the scientists better understand how the diseases occur in the first place. And it helps.
So right now there's about 100,000 citizen scientists around the world who participate in folding at home and help us to perform these large calculations. If we can understand how proteins fold, that also means we can understand how they misfold and cause diseases like Alzheimer's disease and start developing therapeutics that would reverse those processes.